Hey, rayodaniel here. Welcome back to the channel. As you realize by this point, the videos that I have on my YouTube channel really focus people on the software program HighLevel. HighLevel is a great sales and marketing platform. It has a lot of extensibility. It can literally run your entire business. Now, unfortunately, there are some things that Gohighlevel cannot do. Gohighlevel, for instance, cannot connect to ChatGPT directly. Now, I'm going to be creating several videos on ChatGPT and using it inside of HighLevel. Well, unfortunately, there are times where we need to connect those two, and we need to use a third party. But before I go any further here, please click to subscribe on this channel. I really do appreciate it. I need the support. If you do like the video, please click like, comment on it, and click the little bell so you get notified whenever I post other videos. I'm really trying to post several videos a week just to kind of help people get informed. So back to it here is within HighLevel and ChatGPT, those two systems cannot communicate directly between them together. So you need a third party. And Zapier, however you want to pronounce it here, I know there's a quandary of how you actually say it. I'm just going to use Zapier. You use Zapier as a third party, and the third party can actually connect Gohighlevel, and it can actually connect to OpenAI or ChatGPT, which is the product of OpenAI. So you will need to get Zapier connected to both systems in order to begin utilizing the connection, so you can start utilizing ChatGPT and some of the other more advanced functions that I'm going to create other videos on my channel in the beginning. But I wanted to show you how to connect those and get the account set up first so that you don't stumble when you're starting to create these inside of Zapier. So right now I do have an account. It's a lowest level paid account that you have, and unfortunately to do the things that we're talking about here, you cannot use the free account with Zapier. You just can't. You have to use some of the things that we're going to be doing are going to be involving the premium webhooks. So you do need to have at least the basic account. I believe it's like 20 bucks a month, and it's maybe a little bit cheaper if you do the yearly plan. But I do have a paid account. I just want to tell you that up front. Inside of Zapier, when you log into your account, you need to go over here on the left-hand side to your MyApps functions. Now, your MyApps are where you basically have all of the connections, the authorized connections between all of the platforms that you want to use Zapier to connect to. So right now, lead connectors, you see on the screen here, lead connector is the HighLevel connector. Now, I already have this connected because I'm already using several Zaps to do some other things, but there's a help article under HighLevel that shows you how to connect the lead connector app, authenticate, and actually connect it to your HighLevel account. So that part we've already done. What I would like to do is connect two other systems today. I'd like to actually connect Zapier to OpenAI, and I'd like to connect Zapier to Google My Business, because I'm going to be creating videos that involve both of those connections, and I wanted to just create this video right now to show you how to make these connections without wasting sort of the time in those videos to kind of go through the creation connection process. So here, you're just going to simply add a connection. I'm going to do OpenAI first. So you would just simply type in OpenAI. You see you have the OpenAI app. So you're going to click on that, and it's going to load this. Now, what this is going to do is, in order for Zapier to connect to OpenAI, you need to generate an API key. Now, an API key is a very specific, long, like 30-something digit alphanumeric number that uniquely identifies an individual user who's utilizing that system. Excuse me. But just the best practice, you should use one API key per person that's utilizing this system to really track in case something goes wrong or somebody does something that you want to be able to track and audit. You want to be able to make sure that their API key is attached to it so you can find out where the problem is or maybe who misused the system. So right now I'm going to leave this screen open on Zapier, and I'm going to hop back over to our OpenAI account. Now here, when I log into, you're just going to go to platform.openai.com. Now, if you don't have an account created, that's the first thing you need to do. Go and create an account with OpenAI. This will get you logged in. And once you're logged in to the OpenAI, you're just going to click on your name over here and go to View API Keys. Now, here's where you generate all of your API keys for the system. So right now, we're just going to do Create New Secret Key. And forgive me, I know I have to blur this out. You really shouldn't share your API key, but I'm just going to copy it. And I'm going to click OK. So now I'm going to come back in here to Zapier and pop the screen back open again. I'm going to put in the API key and say connect. Now, when that happens, now we have a new connection with OpenAI. That's all that needs to be done. So right now, moving forward, you can create any Zaps where you have OpenAI as a way of getting information to, or getting information from. You can do either one of those, and you can just simply choose OpenAI now because you already have this connection established. So I just recommend coming in here and getting the connection established first. That way you don't have to deal with trying to create the connections while you're building the Zaps later. So right now, this is how we would connect to OpenAI. As you saw, it was pretty straightforward. Generate an API key, copy it, paste it into the screen. It creates an account, and now everything should be good to go. And I believe if you come over here and refresh it, you see over here the API key that gives you this column that says last use. These say never because we haven't actually done anything with this API call yet. So as we begin utilizing it, it will show you the last time, the last date that it was actually utilized. So that's all we're going to do inside of OpenAI. Pretty straightforward to get the account set up. Now what we want to do is actually set up Google My Business account. So right now we want to set up, just type in Google. As you see, there's several different areas of Google that you can connect to, one of which is Google My Business. Now we're going to connect to Google My Business because we want to make sure that we can actually connect to this, and we're going to be using ChatGPT to do an automatic response to Google reviews. This is a service that as a marketing agency, you could sell to your clients. You can add it as a digital value added service, but this is just something that I want to be able to give to you to improve your business and maybe even create an additional revenue stream. So I know I'm kind of jumping the gun here, but let's go ahead and get logged in. You're going to just choose your Google account. When you come in here, you do need to sit back and allow edit, delete for your Google My Business because the connection will need to make changes. So you will have to check this box and click continue. Whenever you do this, now you will see you have Google My Business and you can go back to your main app screen. So now we have OpenAI and Google My Business connections successfully done. At this particular point, now we can come into the Zap screen and we can begin using these Zaps, using those connections inside of the Zap. So this, all I wanna do for this video is just create them, show you how to create the connections. In the other videos, check out on my channel, I'll begin utilizing Zapier to make connections and provide additional value-added functions for GoHighLevel and its other features. Thanks so much for visiting the channel. Again, please click the subscribe and like on this video if you found it useful. I would appreciate the support and have a great day. Hey, I want to thank you again for visiting my channel and give you one more little thing here. If you are interested in HighLevel and getting some additional HighLevel training, please see the link in the description below. I do have a free course I'm offering that covers everything related to HighLevel and gives you all the information that you need to know. Thank you so much and have a great day.